My name is Dr. Raphaela Goldbach-Mansky, and I'm chief of the Translational Autoinflammatory Disease Studies section at the Laboratory of Clinical Immunology and Microbiology at the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases.
My name is Dr. Gina Montealegre. I am a pediatric rheumatologist by training. I do work at the Translational Autoinflammatory Disease section led by Dr. Goldbach-Mansky at the National Institutes of Health.
In the paper, we are summarizing data from a compassionate use program treating patients with two rare genetic diseases, CANDLE and SAVI, with a JAK1 and JAK2 inhibitor, baricitinib. CANDLE is caused by loss of function mutations in genes that encode proteasome components, which assemble recycling units for proteins that are marked for degradation. Patients present with fevers, rashes, inflammation in the fat, as well as muscles, and chronic pain. Many of them also develop metabolic syndrome that manifests itself as with hypertension and hepatic steatosis. SAVI is caused by mutations in TMEM173, a gene that encodes a viral sensor and adapter that, when activated, leads to the production of type 1 interferon or interferon beta. They present with cold-induced vasculitis that, if chronic, can lead to the loss of fingers, and with progressive interstitial lung disease. We have successfully used strategies that block cytokine signaling in other autoinflammatory diseases. However, patients with CANDLE and SAVI did not respond to these treatments. Patients with CANDLE and SAVI carry a chronic interferon signature in the blood that suggests chronic upregulation of interferon signaling. We therefore hypothesized that treatment with agents that target the interferon signaling may lead to amelioration of the disease. In 2011, when we needed to treat a sick patient with CANDLE, drugs that block interferon signaling had not been approved by the Food and Drug Administration. We were lucky to obtain baricitinib, a JAK1, JAK2 inhibitor that in the lab had interferon blocking capacities as treatment for these young children. Baricitinib at that time was in clinical trials for rheumatoid arthritis.
In the expanded access program, we enrolled 18 patients, 10 patients with CANDLE, 4 patients with SAVI, and 4 patients with other interferon-mediated diseases. All of them had not responded to conventional treatment uses to treat IL-1-mediated autoinflammatory diseases or other pediatric rheumatological conditions such as lupus or juvenile idiopathic arthritis. However, when we started to treat our patients with the JAK1, JAK2 inhibitor baricitinib, patients reported to feel better pretty quickly. All the chronic symptoms, the recurrent fevers, the painful rashes, the musculoskeletal pain improved. In all patients, the appetite actually improved as well. Many of the patients who were underweight at baseline, they were able to grow and they were able to gain weight. These patients were in chronic doses of oral corticosteroids, and we were able to gradually reduce the daily dose requirements for them. And the side effects associated to these exposures in most of them were reverse. The response to baricitinib was more complete in CANDLE patients. 50% of our patients were able to achieve clinical and inflammatory remission criteria. More interesting, those patients who were able to achieve inflammatory and remission criteria were able to normalize their interferon scores. We were chronically elevated at baseline, indicating that baricitinib was able to target the interferon pathway or the amplification loop effectively. In SAVI patients, that response was more like tissue protective. None of our patients had tissue lost during winter, that it was the most difficult time for them. And the main cause of morbidity and mortality for these patients, that is the interstitial lung disease, did not progress and stabilize on treatment. Hormone receptors such as growth hormone and erythropoietin also signal through the JAK-STAT pathway. We were reassured that our patients were able to continue to grow. They continued to improve their bone mineral density, and their hemoglobin values improved while on treatment with baricitinib.
having seen the suffering of the children with rounds and rounds of ineffective treatments, to see some of the changes on treatment have been very rewarding.
It has been fantastic because a lot of them, they were emancipated, so they were actually teenagers that have not been going to school, they have never dated, they have never go outside because of the way that they feel and the way that they look. And now they're just coming back to the NIH being a completely different person.